Today we're watching Top 10 Guitarists of All Time, a list compiled by Watchmojo. This topic is always rife with controversy. In my own personal, humble opinion, I think the reason for that is because some people think the quality of music is objective. I don't think that's the whole story, though. There are many subjective components that are involved when it comes to assessing the quality of musical art. That being said, people's personal opinions are going to vary quite a bit. So without any more drama, let's see what Watchmojo has in store for us here. Please note DJ Khaled.
The guitar is their weapon of choice.
Excuse me while I kiss this guy.
Jimi Hendrix is the first person we see.
Welcome.
Is it, excuse me, will I kiss the sky or kiss this guy? That's the real question, right?
To WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 guitarists of all time. For this list, we've chosen guitarists based on a combination of their talent, songwriting skills,
Buckethead,
and creative merits,
Frank Zappa,
and their lasting
BB King.
If you want to learn more about great axemen,
R.I.P. to BB King.
If you're expecting to see Brian May or Carlos Santana on the list, be sure to check out our videos
Mr.
on the top
Steve
10
Vai
solo
playing Tender Surrender,
top 10 band guitarists. And for even more guitar gods, check out our instrumental series. Number 10. Randy Rhoads.
Oh, this is most likely going to get copyrighted.
Rhoads exploded into the heavy metal universe after giving Ozzy Osbourne's music a new lease on life.
Randy Rhoads is incredible. There's no doubt about it.
Though Randy Rhoads' time with
Crazy Train.
And Quiet
Have you ever heard the same
that,
train, though?
Brief. The classical guitar devotee left a legacy that is unparalleled to this day. Despite his short 25-year life, he'll always be remembered for his ability to make a whole lot of noise with
yeah,
his
Yeah, age 25, got in
effects.
A plane crash. Private plane went down. Just imagine what Randy would be today.
Number 9, David Gilmour.
Lord Gilmour.
Though the multi-talented musician played several different roles in Pink Floyd, he proved to be at his best when playing the guitar. David Gilmour's blues-inspired style and evocative notes have produced some of the greatest guitar
evocative
in
notes.
History.
Comfortably dumb. I mean, numb.
Simply watch a live performance of Gilmour's guitar work on Comfortably Numb.
This man can make you feel something. There's no doubt. That descending line just gets me every time.
Number 8, Stevie Ray Vaughan. With
All
his
right,
passionate
SRV.
And expressive playing style, SRV brought life back into blues rock. He differentiated himself from those before him by blending blues, rock, and
Dude,
jazz.
Dude, really had the blues
a fatal
in him.
Helicopter crash may have taken his
Played
life,
13 gauge strings, basically
music
piano
will
wire.
To live on, thanks to his work with Double Trouble and the impact he's had on future generations of artists.
He died at, I think, age 35 in a
Number
helicopter
seven,
accident.
BB King.
Plane crash
the King
for Randy,
of blues did
helicopter
not only
accident.
Perfect the method of
SRV.
Using the
Stay out of aviation. Sort of things in general, if you're a musician, I think is
but
the secret.
But he also demonstrated this feat on numerous occasions with his own guitar, Lucille. And thanks to his soloing style and exceptional vibrato, B.B.
Yes.
King has become the
one
ultimate
finger
inspiration
vibrato.
To many of the biggest electric and blues
finger.
Rock guitarists after him.
His facial expressions are probably the best part about watching him play.
Number 6, Chuck Berry.
Oh, yes.
We have Chuck Berry's thrilling sound and remarkable playing style to thank for rock and roll's growth and subsequent explosion. By bringing
a real showman
and guitar solos to the genre, he became a huge influence on rock music. Meanwhile, his stage bravado
there you go. There's
and
that move.
Dance moves
Angus Young kind of picked up on that, did his own version of it.
Number 5,
Johnny
Robert
B. Bad.
He must have really traded his soul to the devil for his talents because his guitar playing style was so complex that few can match it.
I love
day.
The Faustian bargain concept in music. You know, this idea of I'll give you my soul, devil, and you give me unlimited musical power. It's been around for a long time. And apparently Robert Johnson made that deal. Dump it.
In addition to his impressive technical capacities, Robert Johnson could express a wide range of emotions through his voice, and this made him an all-around musical legend. Despite his early death at age 27,
that's not
there's
actually
no
Robert Johnson.
The
I don't think we have any
Delta
footage
blues
of him.
Had a major impact on rock and roll.
Give me your right hand.
Number 4, Eric Clapton. Slowhand developed an unmatchable style that he's used both as a solo artist and as a member of bands like Cream and the Yardbirds.
Slowhand. That's not necessarily the most flattering nickname to have as a guitar player, but we still love you, Eric. Layla. I always wanted to hear Slayla. You know, if Slayer would make a version of Layla, but call it Slayla. Kerry King, if you're listening, please, can we please make that happen? Thank you.
Eric Clapton even coined a signature guitar sound known as the woman tone. Plus, his ear for melody is untouchable.
Huh?
On top of that, Clapton is one half of the team behind one of rock's greatest love songs. And he played its memorable riff with another one of the most innovative guitarists in history, Duane Allman. Number 3. Eddie Van Halen.
Yes.
He burst onto the scene with his drumming brother Alex and
Eddie
co-founded one
best.
Of the biggest hard rock acts in American history. Eddie Van Halen revolutionized guitar playing with his tapping technique and
million
hard
dollar
rock
smile.
Style.
Classic, having the cigarette in your headstock.
While he continues to play with Van Halen, his originality and talent have already inspired many and will certainly inspire scores more.
Yeah, that one cuts us deep. That was just last year in 2020 that he passed away. R.I.P. EVH. Jimmy Page, number 2.
Both as a co-founder of the biggest band of the 70s and as a musician in his own right, Jimmy Page permanently altered the sound of music by fusing blues, rock, and folk.
An incredible creative force in Jimmy Page.
Seen, as aptly displayed in Led Zeppelin's Stairway
that
to Heaven.
That was a riff machine. Stairway
Though
to Hell.
He was influenced by Robert Johnson,
I mean,
the
heaven.
Riff King himself has left an immeasurable and all-encompassing influence on later artists that won't soon be
this
forgotten.
That's true. A whole lot of hate, a lot of love.
Before we unveil our number
I can't
one
help.
Pick, here
can't
are
help
a
that.
Few honorable mentions.
Joe. Give it to me, Joe. Okay, Dimebag. Look at Phil in the back, soaking it in. Ridiculous talent. Jeff Beck. He was a master wanker with the whammy bar. You know what I'm talking about? Tony. Angus. Did you do the Chuck Berry move here? Oh, that's a different move. Knee move. I want to make a point here. I love the spirit of Jimi Hendrix's playing. We're so up in our heads these days about being guitar heroes. We're hyper self-conscious. We're always kind of locked in this dick measuring contest. You can play faster and better. And Hendrix wasn't afraid to just explore live on stage, right? He would sometimes go off the rails and you would hear it and there would be mistakes, but who cares? You know, he was on this journey of self-exploration and taking chances, and you have to respect that, and it led to a lot of cool sounds. Can we get more of that in today's shredders? You know, instead of being so hyper self-conscious about trying to impress the next guy, they're not even listening anyways. We should try to impress the babes instead, and you have to do that with feeling.
Do you agree with our list? Who's your favorite guitarist of all time? Don't forget to check out our videos on
Eric
the top
Johnson.
10 solo guitarists, top 10 band guitarists,
sorry, EJ,
and
didn't
our
make
top
the
10
list.
Instrumental series for more of your favorite Axemen. And be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com
Santana.
For more top 10s published every day.
There's Watchmojo's top 10 guitarists of all time. What do you think of this list? Put your own list down below. I want to know, do you think music and the quality of music is subjective or objective? Or is it maybe some combination of both? Let's talk some philosophy. Now, I will say that in 2021 and beyond, guitar has reached an insane level of advancement. So to compete and to be on a top 10 list like this, you have to take things further. One way to do that is to become educated in music theory so that you can actually be more of a composer. Imagine if you were a guy like John Williams, you know, the film composer, but you could also shred on guitar. That's what I think we see in examples like Michael Romeo of Symphony X. But you got to know your theory to be able to do that. So check out my music theory course below. Good news, it just costs you your soul.